Hi, and welcome back to Community Hotline. Glad you stayed with us, because tonight now we have with us from the Sandy Actors Theater and Readers Theater of Gresham, Tim Park, who is the director of the leading ladies performance at Sandy Actors Theater, and Kathy Strickland is the producer. Thanks so much for being here, both of you.
Thank you.
Tim, you've been my guest several times. Always a pleasure to have you on the show.
Yes.
Kathy, this is your first time on the show?
This is it.
Yes, good. Well, you'll be back again.
Always a pleasure.
Are you
saying that sincerely?
I mean it. Okay. You're always a good guest, Tim. So tell, just for those who may not have caught a previous appearance by the infamous Tim Park, tell us a little bit about the theaters themselves and what you do in the community.
Okay, Sandy Actors Theater has been around since 1976. It's one of the oldest community theaters in Oregon. We do 5 main stage shows per year, starting in September and going through until June. Then we also have another program called Readers Theater Gresham, which we do in Gresham, obviously.
Yes.
And that is where we do a single performance once a month from October through May, and that is a Readers Theater performance where there's no set or costumes or anything, any amenities that,
right,
you know, along with the script. The emphasis is on the text itself, and it's pretty amazing the effect that just has when people are simply reading. They're actually acting, definitely.
Right. You know, I know. The first time I heard about that, I was a little confused, even though I knew about Readers Theater, but trying to imagine as the actor if that was harder or easier. And I think it would be harder to be able to convey some of the, I don't know, what do you think?
If you know the storyline when you're going in, you can certainly convey, just like you do on stage, and to the audience, especially the older audience that used to sit around and listen to the radio,
this is what
it's all about. And you can literally close your eyes and imagine you're sitting in front of the radio listening to an old show.
Well, I've seen a couple snippets of some of the performances, and they're pretty amazing. They're pretty amazing.
Although I would say that doing a full show is a lot more work.
Yeah. just the set design itself and the costumes and everything else is a huge thing there.
And figuring out all the movement and the getting the timing right and the memorizing lines and the interaction
Walking
between
all, that, yeah.
all the characters.
Tim and I seem to choose the very hardest
do
ones,
you?
Do we?
Do you?
Well, this has been a great show now, but it's not been an easy show to put together.
Okay, so tell me, Kathy, maybe you could tell me a little bit about Leading Ladies. What is that show about?
Well, it's about a couple of down-and-out Shakespearean actors from England who have come to their lowest point where their big show, their big gig is at the local Moose Lodge in Pennsylvania, in Shrewsbury, Pennsylvania.
Okay.
And they read an article in the paper stating that a millionaire woman is giving away some of her millions and she's dying and she's looking for her lost relatives. Well, not reading the full article, they find out that it's not nieces, but I mean not nephews, but nieces that she's looking for, but they're assuming that it's nephews, and so that's where the whole con comes about.
And so they decide to keep going ahead with the whole idea,
yes,
even after they find out that it's nieces, which makes for an awful lot of twists in the plot.
And a lot of
some very confusing relationships.
So the leads are men.
The leads are very
Now, I think we have
men.
Some pictures from that. So maybe we can show some of those pictures from Leading Ladies, and maybe you can kind of walk us through and tell us what we're looking at in that. So
I should say this is written by Ken Ludwig, who's one of the best known comedy writers, playwrights in America. He wrote Lend Me a Tenor and a number of other shows that have been on Broadway. So it is hilarious. And I just happened to bring the review that was in the paper, and it says Leading Ladies rocks sat. And
nice.
It does rock.
Cool. Nice review then, huh? So what are we looking at here?
Well, these are our lovely ladies here with
oh, they're lovely.
Doc. And they're just now meeting the crowd in this one. They're just now meeting the people at this nice home in York, Pennsylvania, and setting their characters up.
Yes, and see, they have the costumes from, they only have seven costumes because they're pretty, like she said, down and out. But one of them is Cleopatra, and the other is Titania, Queen of the Fairies from Midsummer Night's Dream.
So they're wearing
with
those
the
costumes
fairy wings.
Because
yes.
That's all they have. Oh, mm-hmm. How funny is that?
Oh, and this is, and so they decide to do a performance of Twelfth Night, and Leo, who's really the spearheading everything and the whole idea, Jack, his friend, follows along. He gets the idea that the group of people at the house will do this performance of Twelfth Night, and this is one of our younger actors.
And I'm telling you, I've got to put
it is, this. He's hilarious.
He is the funniest character. I mean, he has it down pat. His line is, "But I look like a broomstick."
A broom with shoes.
Broom with shoes on, and he's so funny. It's so funny. I crack
it.
Up every time.
And this is in the front here is Aunt Florence, who seems to die about five different times during the play, and somehow comes back to life. And this is her having her first attack, where she's gotten so mad at Doc that she has a heart attack. But she survives and continues to survive because she's just too stubborn to die.
Okay.
She's a very funny character.
And a romance ensues. I mean, this is what it's all about. They just naturally are attracted to one another. Even though Leo plays the part of a woman and himself in the play, Meg is attracted to him both as the woman and the man. She confesses to him that she's very attracted to her and loves her.
Oh no, how funny.
So
yeah, it's much more than that.
So there's a lot to this play. It's
there's a lot
of different
to this.
It, how many people
hilarious.
Are in it? How many how big is your cast?
There's eight.
Eight people in the cast.
Eight
well,
plus
nine
altogether,
yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
And it builds, you know, it starts out where you're learning all of the characters and all of the scenes and where they're at, the actual placement, and it builds and it builds. When we get to the second half, I'm telling you, there's no stopping. And I tell people, you know, exercise their cheeks before they come.
They're going to be hurting, aren't they?
Yes, we laugh so much. I've seen it, I don't know how many times, and Tim, of course, too. And I can't stop laughing every time I see it.
I love it.
I have
great.
Never stopped enjoying watching it.
That's really saying something for the producer and the director to not be sick and tired of it.
We've got such a fabulous cast.
The cast is amazing.
And they're so inventive, creative. They've come up with some things just to add a little bit to it and make it interesting.
Well, they're professionals, even if they're not.
They are professionals.
These guys are professionals.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. It's
I was
fun.
Really, really pleased getting this cast.
Wow.
I was told by someone... Tobias Anderson, in fact,
yes,
that 90% of a good show is finding the right cast, and we found.
Doesn't that feel good?
Absolutely.
We had the auditions, and we looked at each other after the auditions, and how can we be so lucky?
Yes. Isn't that great?
It wasn't
it's so
hard.
Nice when everything comes together, huh?
Yes.
Right.
So this performance will go on until December 2nd.
Yes.
Is that correct?
Right.
Okay, and this is at the Sandy Actors Theater in Sandy.
In Sandy,
Sandy. Okay.
Right
and
behind Ace Hardware.
Oh, of course.
And reservations are strongly...
Yes.
No, they are...
Recommended to get
recommended,
reservations.
Or more than recommended.
So
they
you're doing well, especially if you're getting this kind of a review.
Yes.
Then...
Well, we had we had the best opening weekend we've ever had.
Ever? Oh,
yes,
wonderful.
We had a full house on Sunday afternoon. We had to turn a number of people away, which I don't like doing, but we don't have any place.
What do you do? So. That's great. What a
we
great
have
deal.
People coming as far away as Sherwood, Salem, you know, different places.
Kathy, how long have you been involved with the theater?
Since the board reorganized in 2005, I believe it was.
Yeah. Do you have a history of acting or producing?
None
or
whatsoever. It was
really?
Always my inspiration, but
really?
Never had the the nerve.
So how
to
did
do
you
it.
Happen to get into this? And what
well,
what
I was just asked
it?
To come on board as the secretary. They needed a secretary on the board, uh-huh. and you know, everything goes from there. I've volunteered for various things all uh-huh. my life, and this was just another volunteer opportunity.
But obviously one that kind of
she's
got
done
you.
An awful lot.
I've acted
she's
in
the not the secretary, but the treasurer now. And she has been a producer.
Twice.
She was the producer for the play I did last spring also.
I bet you that's
and
something you thought you'd do.
We were in a show about
you're
2 years ago
so
together.
So you do act also.
Yes, yeah, I did.
She
yes,
has
yes.
run lights and sound. And,
and isn't that great to start out volunteering at something and end up learning all sorts of new things?
Well, this that brings up something really important, and that's that yes. Sandy Actors Theatre is an all-volunteer organization, and we do some really good shows, and quite a few of them for a small theater.
Mm-hmm. Yes, you do.
But it's all volunteers, and we always need more people.
So you need more people. I'm sure you can always use donations of money and whatever.
Because we are a 501c3.
Yes. Right. So people write that off if they, you know, yeah, if they're right. theater buffs and want to mm-hmm. donate their money there. And as far as volunteers, if somebody were interested in becoming part of the Sandy Actors Theatre, what kinds of things are available for them to do?
Whatever they
ways.
Want. Okay, the first thing is we need people who are in construction and carpenters.
Mm. Okay.
Because we, right now, are a little bit low on that, and we need somebody to sort of act as a foreman to build sets.
Yeah.
We have some people who will help.
A lot of people wouldn't think about it, and there's a lot of people who have talent in that area.
It's a huge thing. We've got to have sets, and the one you just saw took us 5 weeks to build.
Wow.
So
that's a big undertaking.
We can always use more people to do that.
And then people just paint the sets and decorate.
And that's something anybody could do with some supervision, you know, this is what we're looking for.
Well, it's a joke around our place. Volunteers can even clean the toilets.
Wow, how lucky. What a great deal.
What a deal.
We have people that work concessions. We have people that operate the sound or the light boards.
And you can teach them if
it's
they don't know how to do that.
It's a learning opportunity if that's what they want.
And anybody can audition.
To perform?
Yes. Yep. You don't have to have any experience.
How fun.
So
how fun.
It's a
it
learning
sounds like a really fun group to work with.
We are a fun group. I've got to say that. I've been with them so long. It is like a family. Uh-huh. We all know each other. We're concerned about each other's families and what goes on in our lives. And we know that most of us are very, very dedicated to the theater and spend a lot of time there.
Right.
And sometimes we have to explain that to our significant other.
Well, I'm sure. And I'm sure you know, most of the people have other things going on in their lives, full-time jobs.
Absolutely.
I know you have a full-time job. Yeah. Are you retired yet? You were going to retire. I remember you said that.
Yes and no.
Okay.
Yes.
I remember you talked about that.
Sort of.
The post office?
Yes.
Yes, that's what I thought. Okay. Yeah. I'm trying to remember here. Yeah. So, you know, most of the people probably have full-time jobs, have families, have other things going on in their life. So the volunteering takes a lot of time, but it sounds very rewarding.
It is rewarding.
So tell me a little bit about a couple more things you have going on. There's another performance going on December 14th and 15th. You better watch out.
14th, 15th, yes. and 16th.
And 16th. Okay, tell me about that.
Well, we decided that we would try to do a Reader's Theater in Sandy. We thought about it for some time, but it came up that we really didn't have a purely Christmas show this year, and we thought that's an ideal time to do that. So we found a play called You Better Watch Out, and we are doing it as a Reader's Theater performance, which will be still pretty lively and exciting, a very, very sweet Christmas story.
Very sweet.
I shouldn't say sweet's not the word. It's touching, nostalgic, makes you laugh, makes you cry.
What were you saying, Kathy?
It's Santa Claus.
Oh. Well, there's Santa Claus, there's a pregnant woman who's having a baby, and they're stuck in a snowstorm. You can tie all these things together.
Yeah. It sounds like it would be a
and
good, appropriate
holiday. This is our reward
holiday.
To our volunteers. This is what we thought we would do for them, is to invite all of the volunteers to come in and watch this and just as a thank you. Also, our season pass holders are welcome to come too.
Oh,
and
nice.
Then anyone else that isn't on that list, we're only charging $8 to see that show. So.
All right, but so you better watch out at the Sandy Actors Theater, yes. And that will be a reading. It won't be the full,
right.
The full
yes.
performance. Okay.
I get to narrate that one.
Pardon?
I get to narrate that
oh,
one.
Oh, you do?
Yes.
Oh, fun. How great to have so many things you can do there and learn new things.
Love
I think
it.
That's great. I bet you do. Broadway Bound by Neil Simon.
Yes, that's our next Reader's Theater.
And that's
now,
in Gresham.
We take December off from the Gresham Reader's Theater program. And so we'll start up again in January. And Broadway Bound is one of Neil Simon's classics. It's the last of his trilogy, which is an autobiographical trilogy, which is, any Neil Simon play is hilarious.
Is fun. Yes,
yes.
They're all fun. So that'll be at the Gresham Chapel and Event Center on January 21st. One time only performance?
Yes.
One time only.
Okay.
I get the privilege of directing that one.
Oh, you
too,
do?
So,
God, yeah. You do keep busy.
Yeah, too busy.
Okay, we're almost out of time. So, Kathy, tell me one thing about the theater that you think people should know.
That when you come in and you see the smiles of the people there, it's genuine.
Oh, good. That's a nice thing to know.
Yeah.
That's a nice thing to know.
I believe it.
It sounds like you have a really fun time. What about you, Tim? What else do you want to add before we're out of time here?
Well, just on Leading Ladies again, I think it is one of the funniest shows
I've ever seen.
And it is nonstop laughing, especially the second act. It's just
so
constant.
So like Kathy said, exercise those,
yes.
those smile muscles,
yes.
otherwise
in
you'll
our
have
warm-up,
sore
we
jaws.
Try to tell everyone,
yes.
you know, huh, you know, get that mouth wide and get an exercise.
Well, good. We'll be looking forward to that. It sounds great. I'm glad you're getting good reviews and that you're doing so well. That's really good to hear. Well, thanks very much, both of you, for being my guests tonight on Community Hotline. Don't go away. We'll be right back with just a few special messages from Community Hotline. Back again for just a moment. I'm Monica Weitzel here on Community Hotline. Wanted to let you know about a couple things that are coming up. Here at MetroEast Community Media, we have a lot of great partnerships, and one of them is with the Portland Columbia Symphony Orchestra. They're a terrific nonprofit organization here in the area. They have a couple performances coming up. One is called A Holiday Gift of Music Concert. It takes place December 2nd at 3 p.m. at the Good Shepherd Community Church in Boring, Oregon. And that's something you might want to check out. Another one is a fundraiser they're going to be having this holiday season called The Little Black Dress Goes Holiday. And that's for you ladies in the area. So get out your little black dresses. It's going to be at Riverview Community Bank in Gresham on Thursday, December 13th from 5:30 to 8:30 p.m. It's a very nominal charge. It's happy hour, and you'll have a great time. Raise some money for the Portland Columbia Symphony Orchestra. We've enjoyed having you here tonight to talk with our theater groups. We hope you tune in next week. I'm Monica Weitzel, and this is Community Hotline.
What does it take to start something? A little time. A little exercise. A little laugh. A little adventure. A little help. That's all it takes to make a big impact.
As he always talks about, he had people in his life that really helped him out, and he wants to be that person in my life.
Just like he is, I was like that at 14. I know exactly what it means to be a 14-year-old guy.
I think that's why we have a good relationship.
He's fun and cool and nice.
You get to see like how personality develops.
Our friendship is good.
At Big Brothers Big Sisters, a little bit of your support can go a long way towards making matches like these happen. Start something today at bigbrothersbigsisters.org/startsomething.